Hello everyone, welcome to our interview series, You with Unicorn. Here we connect with people from different walks of life and understand more about their journey, what works for them and what doesn't. I am Vandana Teji and I have with me today Advocate Amitabh Nihar. Hello Amitabh Ji.
Hi Vanda, thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure to have you here. Advocate Amitabh is a managing partner of XLR Law Office. He's a practicing lawyer in corporate law and litigation. He's also on the advisory board of many startups and SMEs, a postgraduate in business management and a graduate in law. Advocate Amitabh comes with over 25 years of experience in various roles in law firms, investment bank, financial services companies, and banks in India and UAE. Advocate Amitabh has worked with prestigious organizations like Citibank, Emirates, NBD, law firms and financial services companies in both India and UAE. He also works with NGOs and organizations in advisory role for compliance of service of sexual harassment of women at workplace Act 2013 and has represented victims of sexual offenses in district court and high court. Welcome Amitabh Ji. Welcome to You with Unicorn. So Amitabh Ji, while I have given a short brief about your profile, could you share more about your journey?
Vanna, you have covered, you know, almost my entire career, and there's hardly anything left. But I started my career on the business side. I worked in the financial services industry in India, in investment banks and insurance sector. I moved to UAE. There, I worked with Citibank Dubai for around 5 years. I worked with Emirates NBD, and I worked with law firms back in India. And I'm a practicing lawyer. I'm trying to use my experience on the business side, try to leverage it, fuse it with law, and try advise our clients on various legal issues, including POSH. POSH, as you understand, is a very, very important compliance, and there are a lot of questions in the minds of a lot of organizations. So there we use our prior experience and try advise them accordingly.
Wonderful. So, Sam, you know, you have a part, you know, advisory board of MSMEs. So tell us, how has been your experience with regards to the compliance?
See, yes, we work with companies in the MSME sector. We advise them also. And broadly or generally speaking, people carry the same mindset to their workplace also. Their biases, their prejudices against women. It is very well reflected in the minds of even some of the senior most people in leadership positions. Having said that, there are people who are wise, and our experience is that organizations who are complying with POSH, when things go bad, and there may be, see, I'm not saying that females make false accusations, but you know, there are instances where some false accusations have been there, and organizations who have complied to POSH came very, very clean. Having said that, organizations who are not complying with POSH, they are not able to retain quality female employees. So POSH implementation, it is a retention tool also for good employees. It is a hook also for good employees, because MSMEs, they have aspirations to grow. And until or unless they have a conducive environment, culture towards respect of women and implementation of basic laws such as POSH, I don't think they can give a professional environment, and they can get good investors also. Because investors are also very, very careful whether organization are taking care of women employees and POSH laws and gender sensitivities. You know, these things are taken care of by the board of directors and senior management.
Indeed, indeed. And you very well stated the point that despite, you know, how good the other practices or policies of an organization are, in case the organization is not compliant with POSH and is not providing or promising a safe workplace to women, I think women are happily leaving those organizations. And today, women are in a much more stronger position to make that decision, because more and more companies are being compliant, but yes, there's still a lot of scope to improve.
Oh, yes, I agree. More and more companies are finding it very, very important, not just in terms of compliance, but even otherwise, to have a good culture, professional environment. They very well understand that women, they are very, very, you know, at times they are more confident than their male counterparts. And in case if there is any posh issue, then lot of bad publicity will be created. Media is very hostile, and rightly so. So it is very important for them to comply with posh in letter and spirit. When I say letter and spirit, in metros, we have seen, Vandana, that people are complying with this law. But there are a lot of people who are just doing it for the sake of formality. They'll just tick the box. They'll not look at what the law says in spirit. They are not truly, you know, implementing in terms of training and sensitization of employees, which is very, very critical. Not only this, their HR department also, I think, capacity building and training of HR employees to position the posh laws, to create awareness, as well as IC members should know a few basic principles of law so that they can effectively, you know, investigate any case.
That's so true. In fact, on the same lines, I would like to ask, you know, what has been your observations with regards to employees being aware about their rights in an organization?
Again, I'll say that, you know, the same mindset. You know, females in a lot of matrimonial disputes, we have observed that they don't come forward generally because of a couple of reasons. One is they don't get support from the family. Victim shaming. And the same thing is happening in the organizations also. More so when accused is at a senior position.
Indeed.
They're the females. They shy away from making complaints. They just leave the organization. It is actually very bad for the overall morale of the employees. So females, yes, of course, number of complaints are increasing, but I still think that a lot of females don't complain to IC or even raise the issue with HR, although they're supposed to raise it with IC. The reason being, they don't believe that, you know, IC will effectively adjudicate the incident. That's number one. And number two, there's a lot of hostile environment which HR has to take care in terms of culture of the organization. So until unless we take care of these soft aspects, I don't think that, you know, we can effectively implement posh in letter and spirit.
Indeed. In fact, when it comes to the culture of the organization, I personally think that it is not just the responsibility of an HR person. It's the entire organization. They have to create a culture of trust. If that is not there, doesn't matter, you know, a handful of HR, what they say, because the culture is made by the entire organization, not by just one department. And very rightly said, and the organizations will have to create a system of trust so that, you know, and just saying open door policy doesn't work. Just having an IC doesn't work. How much you work towards creating awareness and giving unbiased decision, going ahead and taking that difficult decision and difficult route, giving the IC the power of civil code, not just saying it. So, very right. You know, Amitaji, I couldn't agree more. Aapne bilkul sahi baat boli hai. In fact, you know, on the contrary, despite strong act in the place, you know, still I don't know why posh is not being adhered to. What is your thought process? Why, you know, the organizations are still not compliant? I see a lot of MSMEs, a lot of medium-sized and large-sized organizations also not having, you know, an IC in place, not conducting training, awareness trainings, such minor hygiene things, which is now mandated by the Act. And this is the only Act which can even lead to the termination of your company registration. Still, people are not following. Why?
It's a mindset issue. Nothing more than that. And people are probably not aware of the consequences. In terms of non-compliance, they think that, you know, there may be a penalty and they will, you know, pay the penalty. It will not stop there. The consequences are very bad for business. Posh implementation and other legal compliances are part of risk management. If they are not doing it right, then they will have to pay huge cost. Huge cost, as I said, in the private sector, no investor will come forward and put money in any organization. No good employee would like to join any organization. So in terms of, you know, retention tool and, you know, attracting good talent, of course, they cannot do it until unless they give a culture where women is respected and acts like POSH are implemented in letter and spirit. Vanna, I feel that, you know, we are focusing on metropolitan cities, but it is very important that NGOs should go aggressively in tier two and tier three cities, in the schools, in colleges, because from there, the thought process of individuals are developed. And until or unless people are aware in senior secondary school, in colleges, in small organizations, that we have to mandatorily respect a woman. And POSH has clarified a lot of confusion as far as sexual harassment definition is concerned, as far as workplace is concerned. So it is in our psyche that we don't care about what is happening to women. Crime against women is generally rising a lot, and same is reflected in POSH. I mean, sexual harassment incidents within the organization.
Correct. In fact, you know, government has mandated the reporting of cases also. However, the fact is that, you know, I think the need of the hour is also to have a, you know, gender agnostic POSH policy, not just limited to women, because we also get to hear a lot about, you know, sexual harassment of, you know, people from other genders as well.
Yes, I'll agree with you completely. In fact, I had an occasion of representing a victim who was a male, and it was a male victim who was harassed by a male senior employee who was actually at a very, very senior level. He was in a leadership role. And there we had to go up to high court and represent the person. And POSH should definitely look at such instances, you know, homosexuals or even males, they can look at it. But by and large, there are enough, you know, aspects covered in the code of conduct and under Indian Penal Code. But POSH for women, I think, is still a lot need to be done. And we can take care of
That is always there. In fact, you know, in my experience, I have met with employers who are themselves, you know, they want me to be a part of the committee. However, you know, conducting awareness trainings and something is that is, they really don't think too much about it. They are like, you know, isse kya hota hai, madam? Kind of those statements, you know. And I say that baat karne se hi baat banti hai. Aap jab tak baat nahi shuru karna shuru karoge, tab tak aage kaise badhenge? So this is what I usually tell them. But then that's a very common mentality. And as you have rightly stated, a lot of things are mindset issues.
Vanna, not just mindset issues. I think that at the cost of repetition, let me re-emphasize. In one of the cases, a women employee, she made accusations against multiple senior management level employees. And the company could complain only because they implemented POSH in letter and spirit. So POSH is not just good for women. It is not just good for employees. It is not just our social responsibility, but in terms of compliance also, but it is a very, very important legal risk management tool. Otherwise, the companies can get destroyed if there are a couple of POSH related incidents.
So coming to, you know, while this our discussion is never ending, I believe, but, and be, you know, but in the interest of time, my last question to you is that, you know, how can, you know, employers create a safe workplace for, you know, their employees? What all can be done?
See, I believe that it is very important to have refresher training programs. There is a requirement under the Act also that the names and, you know, contact number of IC members are displayed. These should be displayed. Refresher programs have to be conducted. HR and departmental heads and managers, they need to take responsibility to create awareness. And they have to ensure that no hostility is there in case if somebody is making a complaint. Practically, that happens, and this discourages a lot of other women in coming forward and putting forth their complaint. So until or unless they work on multiple levels, be it gender sensitization program, refresher training program under the POSH, and managers be made accountable so that they support victims, they tell them, make them aware about where to approach, how to approach, instilling confidence in women that, you know, if at all anything is happening, irrespective of the position of the accused, the investigation will be impartial. And of course, there won't be any you know, hostility towards the female employee from the colleagues as well as the senior management. That is critical. And that actually will give a lot of confidence to women to come forward and give complaints.
True. Thank you, Amitabh ji. Thank you for giving us your time. But before we let you know, go, you know, any last message for our viewers in general?
In general, see, POSH and other, you know, acts, they are just a way of conveying the message that you cannot, you know, insult a woman, you cannot bully anybody, including the women. And whatever we are doing outside our offices, the same thing eventually will come to our offices. So it is very important if somebody sees, you know, any minor humiliation of women, I'll not use the word crime, then they should come forward. And same thing will be reflected in the office environment also sooner or later.
Indeed. Yes, it is very, very important, and it is the need of the hour, not just from you know, compliance perspective, but also from being an organization of choice perspective. On that note, bye everyone. See you soon with our next guest and more insights. To know more about the Unicorn People and Advocate Amitabh Nihar, click on the links in the description box. Do like, comment, and share this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and receive the notifications. Thank you so much.